So, marine life won the vote. Whoops. Let's try that again. That's better. Let's go have a look. This is a tomato clownfish, Nemo's slightly fatter, more tanned cousin. They live in a symbiotic relationship with a sea anemone. Their slimy coating stops them from being stung, so they get protection, and they do a lot of gardening and security work in return. The larger fish is the female, but it's complicated. If the female dies, her partner becomes a female, and the next biggest male steps up to the plate as the new daddy. Unfortunately, this means in real life, Marlin would have become Marlene, and Nemo would have... well, you get the picture. Yep. Bit weird. If you stick your head into a cave in the shallows, you're likely to see these guys. Chubby cardinal fish. They're nocturnal, so spend their days avoiding sunlight like a teenage gamer. But unlike a teenage gamer, they also make great dads. Once the mum pops out the kids, he'll scoop them up in his mouth and incubate them for a week or so, during which time he doesn't eat. Commitment. You'll never guess what this feather duster looking thing is called. A feather duster worm. Aren't we having fun? The feather parts are tentacles it uses to catch food, but the best part is, if disturbed, okay, I don't enjoy this, but I will repeat, for science, with two feather duster worms. That is satisfying. Alright, that's enough fun for today. Oh my god, there's three of them. I think this is more addictive than cigarettes, so let's move on. The next creature is a monster. It can weigh up to 200 kilograms and live over 100 years. This hefty bivalve is a giant clam. People eat them and they can't run very fast, so they're endangered. They also have light receptors, so will shut if you get too close, and they have sex in a strange way. They pump out hundreds of millions of eggs or sperm into the water. If another clam senses this sexy cloud, it sucks it in and mixes it with its own eggs or sperm, resulting in fertilization. If you didn't think you'd hear the term sexy cloud today, you were mistaken. All over the shallows, you can find these decorated holes, seemingly built by a mini marine landscaper. These are the work of the pistol shrimp. It's called pistol because it can cock its claw at an angle of 90 degrees and hammer it down with such force it shoots out a stream of bubbles at 100 kilometers per hour. The bubbles then collapse, reaching a temperature of 4,700 degrees, about as hot as the sun. With weapons this powerful, you wouldn't think it needed friends. But it does. It has terrible eyesight. Enter the humble goby fish. As the shrimp goes about its daily chores, the goby keeps a lookout for danger. If there's a threat, it bats the shrimp with its tail, saying, "Don't come out," before retreating as well. What an inspiring friendship. This is a hawksbill turtle. You can tell it's a hawksbill because it has a hawk's bill, another fantastic display of biologist imagination. They mainly eat sponges, but will also chow down on the occasional jellyfish, even something seriously toxic like the Portuguese man o' war. Sadly, their population has declined 80% in the past 100 years, largely due to us, and the fact they don't really reach sexual maturity until they're 20 years old. When they do eventually reach this age, they make the most of it, with sex lasting up to 24 hours. Can you hear Elton John? 'Cause I can feel the love. Beautiful. Of course, I've saved the best till last. The mighty sea cucumber. I know what you're thinking. Josh, you must be joking. But bear with me. They can live at a depth of 1 meter to 10,000 meters. This is genuinely how some of them eat, like a greedy child at a sweet factory. And if threatened, they can eject sticky tubes out of their butt all over predators, like a cucumber version of Spider-Man. Pretty cool. Now, as this video of me loading a spear gun demonstrates, I'm a bit of a survival expert.
Oh, my fingers are hurting already. What does that feel like? Here we go.
There we go.
Ow! It hit right into a soft spot. I'm bleeding! Am I bleeding? Yeah, I'm bleeding!
He's done it.
Oh God, please stay. Oh God, I hate spearfishing.
So red as well.
Oh, it's so close.
So the next video will either be living off the land on Cempedak, or me moving out of this place and into a hammock on an uninhabited island. Maybe that one over there. Leave a comment down below about what you'd rather see, and I'll see you next time. Bye.